New South Wales has reached a new milestone on our path out of lockdown. 40% of the adult population is now fully vaccinated. But COVID cases are surging too, more than 1,500 in a single day. And tonight, concerns are growing about the mental battle many are facing.
Entering week 11 of lockdown, the tool used to fight a pandemic is creating another one.
We've heard a lot of people talk about a shadow pandemic in mental health. I think it's important to realise it's not in the shadows, it's real, and it is a crisis.
Lifeline CEO John Brogdon knows what it's like to suffer and ask for help.
I have depression, I have suicidal ideation, I know what it's like to live with mental illness, and I know what it's like to live in mental illness during COVID.
Increasing the time allowed out to exercise in the LGAs of concern, according to Lifeline, a lifesaver.
Don't stay in bed all day, that won't help you at all. Get up, get changed, just get some sun on your face, some wind on your face, maybe even some rain on your face, but please get out.
The shining light in our battle is the army of people every day turning out to get vaccinated. Today, New South Wales passed 40% of eligible over 16s who are double vaxxed.
The time has come for people to get real. If they've got any hesitancy, drop it in the basket and get out and put your arm out and get a vaccine.
Authorised workers from the 12 LGAs of concern have until Monday to get their first shot, or
they can't go out to work legally, and they shouldn't.
Our daily case count is the highest yet. 1,533 more people have tested positive. Four more unvaccinated people have lost their lives, including a man in his 60s who died at home. He didn't know he had COVID.
They had not been tested for COVID until after they had died, and so they hadn't been in the care at present of New South Wales Health.
Of the people infected, almost 70% are under the age of 40, and more than 80% are in our west and southwest. Of today's 1,500 new cases, Canterbury-Bankstown has 260, in Cumberland 249 people tested positive, 186 in Blacktown, Penrith 172, Fairfield has 121, there's 112 in Liverpool, 53 in Parramatta, 52 in Campbelltown. Georges River has 38, 34 in Bayside, 21 in Camden. Strathfield has 13, 3 are in Burwood. Not in the LGAs of concern, but with concerning numbers, 21 are in the Inner West and Randwick has 16 new cases. In western New South Wales, 38 new cases, most are in Dubbo with 22. Wilcannia has 9 new infections, the total in that tiny town's cluster now 107. 11,000 people in the state are right now being cared for with COVID. 1,041 of them are in hospital for the first time. That number is more than 1,000. There are 173 people in the ICU, 63 of those on a ventilator. 500 people are in special health accommodation. The rest, around 9,500, are in their homes, receiving phone calls from nurses, being monitored by health teams. Hospital admissions are about to peak. The government will tell us this week just how it plans to deal with demand for treatment in the ICU, which could include fitting out other wards as overflow.
They've got good plans, and will be kept safe.
Lizzie Pearl joins me now in the studio. And Lizzie, there's a fresh vaccination blitz tomorrow.
Yeah, there is, Georgie. Tomorrow we'll focus on police, fire and emergency crews in the LGAs of concern in Sydney's west and southwest. So while these frontline workers have been at the front of the vaccine line for months, tomorrow is another chance to book in and get a priority Pfizer shot. They can do that at Sydney Olympic Park, Bankstown, Macquarie Fields and Prairie Wood. Other authorised workers from those same local government areas can't leave their area to go to work as of Monday if they haven't had a vaccine. That rule doesn't apply to police and emergency services. Also this afternoon at Mount Druitt, more than 250 members of the Aboriginal community, including children aged 12 to 15, received their first COVID shot. Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people are particularly vulnerable to COVID-19, and there are more of these outreach days planned for Western Sydney in the coming weeks, Georgie.
All right, Lizzie, thank you for that. And of course, understanding the mental health issues, it's important that if you or someone you know is struggling to cope, you can contact Lifeline on 13 11 14. The daughter of a terminally ill man has told Nine News she feels pressured to move her father out of Bankstown Hospital to free up his bed. The health system is being pushed to the brink by rising COVID cases. Our paramedics yesterday facing their second busiest day on record.
86-year-old John Sumner is dying from cancer. He can't walk, talk, open his eyes or eat. Too sick to be vaccinated, yet staff at Bankstown Hospital have told his family he's stable enough to be moved to an aged care home.
I don't think he's well enough to move, and they told me ages ago he wasn't, and now he's worse than he was.
Daughter Julie Lamrock wants her father to pass peacefully where he is, but feels pressured to give up his bed.
He hasn't got much longer. Look after him. He's a human being. It's unfair what they're doing and the pressure they're putting on me to say, find a nursing home, find a nursing home. He shouldn't be here anymore.
These are clinical decisions. It's managed by the clinicians. The government certainly doesn't have an input to determining who is in hospital and who isn't.
At Preston's Lodge nursing home, COVID has claimed the life of an elderly man. His wife, among 18 residents and four staff, also infected. As of yesterday, 10 were being treated in hospital, 8 kept in their rooms. A letter sent to families said the South West Sydney Area Health Service, due to a shortage of beds, has directed us to manage these residents on site while they remain stable. Their conditions worsened today and they were moved to higher care. But when the virus spread through the Wyoming facility at Summer Hill, everyone, positive or negative, was moved to hospital as a precaution. Nine News has been told that policy's been scrapped to help with capacity.
The worst case scenario is being kept quiet. The 1,500 cases today, no way near the peak. To cope with transfers, the New South Wales ambulance boss has told staff annual leave may be cancelled and graduates accelerated into the workforce to keep up with demand.
Yesterday was the second busiest day for ambulance that they've had in the state's history. They may call in some other emergency staff to help drive ambulances if they need it.
All we hear are the statistics, but there is a story behind every number. John Sumner doesn't have COVID, but the end of his life is being dictated by it.
It's a bed number thing, and it shouldn't be. He has a right to be there just like anyone else.
Tiffany Genders, Nine News.
Emergency services have been called to Clyde Street at Guildford after the body of a man aged in his 60s was found inside a unit. Ambulance officers are on the scene in full PPE while forensics investigate whether the death is COVID-related.